Most high schools offer some amount of advanced placement courses designed to be more challenging for students while allowing them to potentially earn college credit. While more high school students are taking AP courses than ever before, the amount of diversity in those classes has not kept pace. From WTTW in Chicago, Brandis Friedman reports on what one high school is doing to make sure students aren't left behind.
Students here at Evanston Township High School outside Chicago can take anything from automotive service excellence certification to advanced calculus. They also have their pick of almost 30 advanced placement courses. Dale Liebforth heads AP recruitment.
Portfolio Studio or Latin or, you know, the list goes on. We just added an AP government course.
Even though it's a top-rated school with a diverse student body, until recently, only certain students were picking AP courses.
We had students of color and low-income students terribly underrepresented in our advanced placement courses. There's still a predictability among student achievement in our school district based on race.
When Eric Witherspoon became superintendent 8 years ago, he noticed that AP classrooms were filled with mostly white students, while regular classrooms were filled with mostly minority and often low-income students who make up 41% of the student body. Witherspoon says he realized students were being tracked into AP courses through honors classes based on their eighth grade standardized test performance, while other students were tracked into less rigorous courses.
It didn't take a rocket scientist to figure out that here we're getting disparate results, but in fact, we have a structure that maybe even is causing some of those disparate results, but certainly, if not causing, certainly not doing anything to change those results.
To bridge that gap, Evanston Township High School began enrolling all incoming freshmen in the honors level history and English class called Humanities. Eventually, all ninth grade students, except for those reading below grade level, were also enrolled in honors level biology, no matter how they performed on their eighth grade standardized test. The school is hoping to implement the same strategy for ninth grade math.
We've put a lot of work into convincing students that, you know, this is something that everyone can do. This is a place where you belong, where you have shown that you can show resilience, you can show this grit, you can show the hard work and effort that it takes to be successful.
And which one is further away and generates more volume?
The idea is to set higher expectations of all students early so that more of them are prepared for an AP class by 11th grade. But the work didn't stop there.
The recruitment, the access, the getting, stripping away barriers, we've done that. We've done the easy part, right? Now it's how can you be successful? And so we have instituted just a series of supports for the kids.
The school developed ways to be sure students who enrolled in honors and eventually advanced placement classes didn't fail.
What can we do? What do you think we should do to make that experience for those kids better? Because
one of them is a program called Team Access and Success in Advanced Placement, or Team ASAP. It's a support group for AP students.
It's kind of like a stress reliever. I don't know, just whenever I'm having an issue in one of my classes, I can just kind of come here and talk about it and like talk to other students who might be having the same issue.
This is a great way to just get AP study strategies, and I know that I plan on taking AP classes next year.
Senior Jonathan Senecal says black male students are often still underrepresented, but he says this push to diversify AP classes is making a noticeable difference.
Advanced placement is like traditionally kind of a white space, but like, you know, in recent years we have seen it change a whole lot. I know that even in my stats class, everyone's very well represented, you know, and what it helps to do is, you know, you get a whole lot of unique perspectives, people got different kinds of analogies, they're bringing different things to the table, and everyone really improves just because of that.
The district says early numbers show the changes it's made are making a positive difference for all students. Between 2011 and 2014 alone, the number of students taking the AP exam is up 30%. White students showed a 19% increase, black students taking AP tests are up 35%, and Latino students showed the most growth, up 78% in those 3 years. Not only are more students taking AP tests, but the number of students scoring a 3 or higher, a score that can lead to college credit, is up too. For white students, it's up by 31%, black students by 98%, and Latino students up by a whopping 116%. Northwestern University professor and researcher David Figlio is also an Evanston High School parent. He's volunteering his research expertise to study if and how well these changes are working.
Evanston High has a formula in some regards for success for the advantaged kids. And so any monkeying around with that formula could be risky, and at the same time, it could pay off in big ways. So we need to know this for what's happening with the students who would have been in the honors classes anyway before this has happened, as well as the students who wouldn't have been in the honors classes had this not been happening.
Students say that while they appreciate the increased number of students of color, when they are in class, they should have just one focus.
I feel like there are classes that are more diverse than other classes, but it's not something that you should pay attention to. If it's what you want, then just go after it.
Figlio adds that a community like Evanston is an ideal place to test this model. It's rich in diversity, resources, and the will to make a change, a change that educators hope could be replicated in other districts. I'm Brandis Friedman reporting for the PBS NewsHour from Chicago.